All right, guys, here's the York. It's all bolted in, ready to go. Got the K&N filter on there. Got the oil return into the reservoir on there. So I just want to show you real quick. It's spinning nicely. Okay. We're going to come back over here. If you'll remember from my other video, got the switch here. Got the green light for go. And green light's on. Now, from the other videos you watched, I'll put a link here. That turns on this valve, which opens up this vacuum, which opens up this adjustable diaphragm right here. This is from a 3.0 AC idle up. And that allows this air to bypass through this diaphragm and into the intake. That's what that switch did last time. Well, now I've wired it up to a relay, which is operating the electromagnetic clutch. Try to get that so you guys can see. Okay. So I've got two things happening with the one switch. I'm also going to wire it up. So if you want, you can have an idle up without turning the compressor on. This just supplies power to this accessory as well as any others that I'll additionally add on here later. And that's where that goes. All right, guys, that's it for the video today. Tonight, I should say. There it is again. York onboard air is happening. Now for this return, some people have cut the EGR. I left it in because it actually helps with some gas mileage on the freeway. And I do drive on the freeway every day, so there's different theories about it. That's not the point here. The point is York onboard air switch, flick of a button inside. I've got idle up as well as the onboard air compressor turning on. A lot of people have this rigged up to some funky motorcycle accelerator cable, and it's just, you know, really shoddy. This is actually going to bypass this butterfly valve and allow a little bit extra air in there to bring the idle up to about 1700 or 2000 adjustable. All right, guys, that's it. Have a great time. Please like, subscribe, and share this video if you like this idea. And if you're interested in getting one for yourself, just leave a comment below, and hopefully you can follow the link to a Facebook page where I post a lot of updates, as well as the forum where I have this whole build documented. Loads of pictures, guys. All right. Remember, like, subscribe, and share. Thanks.